for the block, tension and acceleration are anti-parallel. Check in the diagram. For the block, tension and acceleration are anti-parallel. Correct? What is the angle between them? Here the angle is 180 degree, no? Cos 180 is minus 1. So we get minus T into A naught. For the wedge A, this is tension and this is the direction of acceleration. So angle is 0 degree. So plus sign T into A1. Same for B, tension, acceleration. So plus T into A2 is equal to 0, which gives us the result A0 is equal to A1 plus A2. So this is the constraint relation that we needed. We got. Let us say this is equation number 1. Is that okay for everyone? Any doubt, please? Clear? No? Right. Okay. Thank you. Fine. Akash?
Sir, the angle is not changing, sir.
तुझे क्या लग रहा है?
Sir, होना चाहिए ना, वो आगे जा रहा है तो.
आगे जा रहा है तो angle change हो जाएगा. क्यों? ये surface change हो रहा है क्या? मतलब इंक्लाइन से ये वर्टिकल हो गया फिर हॉरिजॉन्टल हो गया
ऊपर वाला पुली नहीं उसके साइड वाला ये बीच वाला ये
इसके साथ फिक्स्ड है बे
सही आगे जाएगा ना तो चेंज नहीं होगा एंगल
तो मतलब इफ यू आर वॉकिंग डाउन द रोड तो तेरा हेड का एंगल स्पिन होता जाएगा वर्टिकल के साथ
नो सर
तब इट इज फिक्स्ड विद द पुली
ओके सर
ओके हां अगर इधर उधर देखता रहेगा तो जरूर एंगल चेंज होगा वो अलग बात है Yes, please. Chalo. So, after getting the constraint, what is the next step? Step 2 was, I have to see or identify the forces acting on different part of the system. So, chalo, for that, we will do one by one. So, now we are going on to step 2. Step 2 is... identifying the forces. So let us work out. For that, I will face the diagram once again. So here I will do one by one. That means for the block we will do, for the wedge A we will do, and then we'll do for the wedge B. Okay, no? Clear? So let me try the picture. Yes, all right. Chalo, let us see. Look at this. Here in this surface, a normal reaction will act in the upward direction. This is, let us say, NA. In the downward direction, what is the force? 4m into g. All right, this is clear. Correct. Check here. Upward direction, normal reaction n suffix b. Downward force is 2m into g. Is that okay? Clear. Chalo, let us think about the tensions. For the block, tension is in that direction. For the pulley, it is in this direction. T. Here also T. Here also T. Is that okay? right? Now let us identify the forces on the small block. Check out. This is mg. So if this is theta, this is also theta. So this will be mg cos theta. Downward force will be mg sin theta. Is there any other force acting? Yes, normal reaction is there. In this direction, we have n suffix small b. Small b refers block. Correct? Okay. Is there any other force? Look at the diagram very closely. Is there any other force? Do you find any other force here? No force? Yes, I can see one force. This NB will have reaction on the wedge. That's it. I request all of you, take your rough copy. Do not refer at the diagram. Find out the forces quickly. Just for mere practice. Do not refer this particular diagram here. You draw the original raw diagram and try to identify the forces. Varun?
Sir, scroll up. Okay.
पुष्कर
सर, वो ब्लॉक ब्लॉक पे जो नॉर्मल लग रहा है उसको वेक्टर्स में नहीं तोड़ने का क्या?
नहीं, वो बाद में,
बाद में,
इस बारे में बाद में बात कर रहा हूँ। Yes, Sriram.
Sir, can you explain the tension force acting on the rope once again?
It's very simple. Tension always acts towards support and away from the body. So if you take the block, this is the direction away from the body.
Yes, sir.
If you take the pulley, so in what direction it should act on the pulley? Away from the pulley.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear now?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, for this pulley also same thing, away from the pulley.
Okay, sir.
Okay, all right. So this is clear to everyone? Understood? Right. So next I am going to do step three. Step three is force analysis. So I will take one by one. That means I will do three diagram for the block, for wedge A and for wedge B, so that we can understand completely. So first let us do for the block. You check for the block. Acceleration I have taken in the downward direction. This is A naught. The wedge itself was moving back with acceleration A1. Correct? All the observations are made from ground. Okay? So where the observer is standing? Observer is standing on the ground. Correct? The moment you take the observer on the wedge, pseudo force has to come, but we did not study about the pseudo force. I will not bring in the concept of pseudo force. Okay. So we are observing from the ground. Tell me one thing. I hope you will all agree with this. Acceleration of the block with respect to ground is equal to acceleration of the block with respect to wedge plus acceleration of the wedge with respect to ground. Will you agree with this? We have studied long back. I hope you remember. Right now? Relative acceleration. Fine. So now if I want to apply this equation, suppose if I want to apply this equation along the wedge surface, applying this equation along wedge surface. It means what? It means we are taking these two as the axis. I hope you got it. This is X and this is Y. Okay, no? Clear? Right. So I have to resolve this component A1, this acceleration A1, along the wedge surface and perpendicular to the wedge surface. If this is theta, this is also going to be theta. So this was going to be A1 cos theta and this is coming as A1 sin theta. Is that idea clear? Right? Fine, no? Tell me now here, applying this equation along the wedge surface, can I write acceleration of the block with respect to ground is equal to A0 minus A1 cos theta? Idea chamka? Is it okay or doubt is there? Tell me one thing. What is the acceleration of the block with respect to wedge? That is A0. Fine, no? What is the acceleration of the wedge with respect to ground in this direction? A1 cos theta. So I have taken this direction as positive. So opposite direction should be negative. So acceleration is coming to be A0 minus A1 cos theta. Now is it clear? Everyone respond. Okay, no? Right? Shashi?
Sir, can you explain again, sir, why minus A1 cos theta came?
Direction. You check the direction. In which direction I have taken the coordinate? This is my x, no?
Yes, sir.
So this is positive x. Opposite to that, this is negative x. This acceleration is along negative x. So that's why minus came. Is it clear now, Shashi? Akash?
Sir, A1 sin theta kahan gaya?
Hai na?
Toh humne usse with respect to ground mein consider kyun nahi kiya?
अबे मेरे को कभी कभी लगता है ना, मैं तेरे से चाइनीज में बात करता हूँ. यहाँ पे पक्का अंग्रेजी में लिखा हुआ है, अप्लाइंग दिस इक्वेशन अलोंग द वेज सरफेस.
ओके सर.
सो वी आर जस्ट रेस्ट्रिक्टिंग आवर सेल्फ इनटू अलोंग द वेज सरफेस. ओके, आई एम कमिंग टू द अदर पार्ट लेटर. ओके, ऑल राइट. चलो, नाउ लेट अस डिस्ट्रीब्यूट द फोर्सेस दैट वी हैव on this particular block along the wedge surface. Quickly tell me, what are the forces we have? In this direction, we have mg sin theta. In the other direction, we have t. Do you have any other forces? No, na? No other forces along the wedge. Check. Correct? Do we have any other forces along the wedge surface? Respond. We don't have only two forces. So what should be the equation? Can I write mg sin theta minus t is equal to mass of the block into acceleration how much? A naught minus A1 cos theta. This is equation number 2. Did you understand this or not? Don't worry, we will do it very slowly. But try to understand every single point. If there is any doubt, immediately tell me. This is okay? Imran?
Sir, yes, sir.
Just identify how many forces are acting along the wedge. How many forces are there?
And tension.
T. Body is sliding in the downward direction.
Yes.
Has lesser force.
Mg sin theta minus T.
That is equal to mass into acceleration. Understood?
Yes.
Yeah, right. Clear, everyone? Respond, please. Yes, okay. Right. Now, force equation perpendicular to the wedge surface. Check out. Now we are applying force equation perpendicular to the wedge surface. All right. So what is going to be the equation perpendicular to the wedge surface? Identify the forces. What are the forces are there? One force is the normal reaction. NB. Opposite direction. MG cos theta. Right. So what is going to be the force? Net force equal to mg cos theta minus normal reaction is equal to, what is the acceleration? M into A1 sin theta. Can you see? This is equation number 3. Any doubt, feel free to go for it. Immediately, don't hesitate. हाँ पुष्कर टेल मी
सर वो ब्लॉक का एक्सेलरेशन हम वेज तक ही रखने वाले थे ना तो ब्लॉक का एक्सेलरेशन जो है ना वो वेज रखने वाले थे ना
नहीं नहीं कहाँ पे बोला मैंने
सर आपने पहले बोला था ना
नहीं मैंने बोला कि वो मैंने लिया आई हैव टेकन दैट एक्सेलरेशन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द वेज बट मैंने यहाँ पे क्लियरली बोल दिया तू तो यहाँ पे खड़ा है भाई सो ऑब्जर्वेशन कहाँ से हो रहा है फ्रॉम ग्राउंड ऑब्जर्वेशन इज बीइंग मेड
ठीक है सर
अंडरस्टूड वी हैव टेकन दैट ए नॉट वैल्यू विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द वेज बट एनालिसिस वी आर डूइंग फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड ओके
ओके
श्रुतिक
सर अलोंग वाई एक्सिस द मोशन इज एक्सेलरेशन इज जीरो ना सर
नो 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 श्रुतिक चेक हियर अगेन आई विल गो बैक एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ द ब्लॉक विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ग्राउंड इज इक्वल टू एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ द ब्लॉक विद रिस्पेक्ट टू वेज प्लस एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ वेज विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ग्राउंड
यस सर
We are applying in which direction now? Perpendicular to the wedge surface.
Yes, sir.
Correct, Shrutik?
Yes, sir.
Can you see that perpendicular to the wedge surface, this factor is equal to zero?
Yes, sir.
Because it was sliding down the surface, along the surface, na?
So in okay, sir. We are observing for ground. Okay.
Yes. So that means acceleration of the block with respect to ground. Is equal to acceleration of wedge with respect to ground in which direction perpendicular to the wedge surface
okay so I thought with respect to wedge that's no. why
I got it. Okay I hope this point is clear now
clear sir
yeah right okay everyone please tell me are these two equations clear for everyone is there any doubt please no doubt no chalo same request I will make to everyone Take your rough copy, take a fresh page, quickly draw this diagram and note down these two equations without referring to this lecture note. If you write two equations perfectly without looking at the lecture note, then only you have understood perfectly. Otherwise, tell me what is the doubt. Okay, Alta, fine. Harshit?
Sir, can I explain third equation, sir?
What you did not understand in the third equation? Tell me that. Tell me precisely sir, what A1. You did not understand.
Sir, how is it A1 sin theta, sir?
Here I have explained. I was answering to Shrutik actually. If you have listened at that time, I told you when we are going to apply this equation once again in the direction which is perpendicular to the wedge surface. So okay. From this equation it is coming, acceleration of the block with respect to ground is equal to acceleration of wedge with respect to ground. How much is the acceleration of wedge with respect to ground? A1 sin theta?
Okay.
So that is going to be the acceleration of the block also with respect to ground.
Okay.
Understood now?
Okay.
Yeah, right. Puskar? Yes, Sriram?
Sir, can you explain once again the second equation?
Which part you did not understand? Tell me precisely. I said just repeating will not help you. Where you are getting stuck? You tell me that part.
Sir, m2 a0 minus a1 cos theta.
Follow this part. Read it once. I am applying the simple format of relative acceleration equation parallel to the wedge surface. Everything is written out there. This is the fundamental equation. Acceleration of block with respect to ground equals to acceleration of block with respect to wedge plus acceleration of wedge with respect to ground. I am going to use this equation along the wedge surface. So along the wedge surface, acceleration of block with respect to wedge is A0. Acceleration of wedge with respect to ground is A1 cos theta. These two are in opposite direction. So A0 minus A cos theta.
Okay, sir.
Okay, fine.
Okay, sir.
So everyone okay? Shall I move ahead now? Chalo. So next we are going to do for the wedge A. So now we'll completely concentrate only on the wedge A. We will not bother about what is happening to the block. Check everyone now. Now force analysis for wedge A. Everyone check out. In this direction, it has acceleration A1. Let us quickly identify the forces. We have already done it previously. This is normal reaction. NA. Downward weight how much? 4M into G. Tension in that direction. Tension in this direction and one more force. NB. Is that okay? These are the forces, no? Check here. Clear now? Forces are okay? Right. So now, see, wedge is accelerating along horizontal direction. So now let us keep my x and y as the original x and y. X, y. So now here we'll write, we will split the forces along horizontal and vertical direction. Correct. Again, take your rough copy. All of you take your rough copy and just split the forces. So this is going to be theta. This is T cos theta. Downward direction, T sin theta. Okay, na? Clear? Right? This also splitting will be done. This is theta. So this is NB cos theta. This one is NB sin theta. Is that okay? Any doubt, please? Altaf?
Sir, niche to NB sin theta bhi le sakte na, sir.
Nahi. Kyun, kyun? That NB sin theta is not acting on the wedge, na? Wo to block ka force hai.
Okay, sir.
Right? Yeah?
Right.
Akash Gadu?
सर जो पुली है वो तो ब्लॉक से कनेक्टेड है ना, तो जो पुली पे टेंशन फोर्स एक्ट कर रहा है वो वेज पे भी करेगा एक्ट.
तुझे दिख रहा है कि पुली ब्लॉक से कनेक्टेड है? मुझे तो नहीं दिख रहा है भाई.
ब्लॉक
तो
नहीं, वेज से. वेज वेज वेज.
हाँ, तो वेज में ही काम कर रहा है ना, इसलिए.
सर मतलब टेंशन वेज पे भी फोर्स एक्ट करेगा?
बिल्कुल. वट एवर फोर्सेस आई एम शोइंग इन दिस डायग्राम, दे आर द फोर्सेस एक्टिंग ऑन द वेज. आई एम नॉट इंटरेस्टेड फॉर एनीथिंग एल्स. द फर्स्ट डायग्राम आई शोड दैट वॉज द फोर्सेस एक्टिंग ऑन द ब्लॉक. Second diagram here, I am only concentrating on the forces acting on the wedge A. No other force.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Understanding? Okay. Mr. Jagannathan Rao?
Hello, sir.
Hi, hi.
Sir, A1 cos theta and A1 sin theta, component division.
Can you see this picture here?
Yes, sir.
Once upon a time, we were in free mind, cool breeze was going on, it was drizzling outside in the romantic atmosphere. Konar said, told, take X and Y as normal X and Y. And he also took the pain to write, we split the forces along horizontal and vertical direction. Movie complete, Rahul Rao?
Yes, sir.
Okay. In cinema hall, yes. Coca-Cola, popcorn are important, but cinematography is more important. Chalo. So now, tell me re, force equation along x-axis. You only tell me. Chalo, look at the diagram and tell me. Force equation along x-axis. Wedge is moving rightward. So what are the rightward forces? T plus NB sin theta. Okay, na? What is the leftward force? Okati. Minus T cos theta is equal to 4M into A1. please respond everyone whether this is okay or not. If this is clear, please respond. Okay, clear. See, if you ultimately look at the things, these things are not difficult, but they just need your time and patience. You have to be extremely patient in solving these kind of questions. Next, force equation. You only tell me, along y-axis, do you find any acceleration along y? No, na? So net upward force equal to net downward force, correct? So what is going to be the equation? Net upward force only one, Na. All of them are downward. 4m into g plus nb cos theta plus t sin theta. Am I right? Check. This is downward. This is downward. This is downward. Only one force, this one is upward. Let us call this as equation number 5. Is that okay? Okay, all right. Again, I will hold on for a couple of minutes. Anyone having any kind of doubt, go for it, please. Don't worry. उसको ये क्वेश्चन क्लियर है. सो दीज टू इक्वेशंस फॉर द वेज ए इज क्लियर अलोंग एक्स एंड वाई. ओके, ऑल राइट, फाइन. शैल वी मूव नाउ? यस. सो नाउ देयर इज ओनली वन थिंग रिमेनिंग. नाउ फोर्स एनालिसिस for wedge B. That one is pending only. Chalo, we will do it. Check here. Force on the B is easy actually. This is pretty easy. There is tension T. Vertically also tension T. Correct? What are the other forces? Normal reaction and weight. No other force is there. Correct? No? NB and 2M into G. And it was accelerating leftward direction with acceleration A2. So it's easy game now. Force on B along x-axis. How much? T is equal to 2m into A2. This is equation number 6. One more equation along y. Simple, very simple. Tell me. Force equation along y axis is equal to NB, NB, NB. Any other force? NB. I'm holding my pen. Plus T. Yes, that is equal to 2mg. That is equation number 7. Done. That's it. Shiva.
Good morning, sir.
Morning, morning, Shiva. Tell me.
Sir, there is one more string now, sir, between block and pulley.
This one.
There tension will not act, sir.
This one?
Yes, sir.
It is irrelevant. Only one here, this tension is acting, na? Perpendicular only. This is horizontal. Angle is 90 degree. So this force will not have any impact over this tension.
No, sir. This not, sir. This downside of that.
This one only I'm talking about. So if you want to check about this string, for this string, here also two forces are there. Horizontal T, vertical T.
Yes, sir.
Understood now?
Okay, sir.
Okay. All right. I will just keep this thing, entire thing right from the beginning. Take 4-5 minutes time, watch everything. Then after that, I will leave 2 minutes for you. You have to take the raw diagram, start from the beginning, constant, and write down the every single equation without referring to anything. Okay, na? Look at this again. This is the constraint we have developed. Then we identify the forces. Correct? All right. Then we did the analysis for B. And from where we are observing? Observer is sitting where? Ground. Okay? Right. We will solve the same question. Remember that we will solve the same question in pseudo force. When we learn about pseudo force, I will solve the same question with pseudo also. Raja?
Sir, agar main lecture note refer nahi kara to, mujhe force analysis pe stuck ho raha hu, sir.
Kahan pe? Wo point mujhe bata.
Identifying the forces, I am getting stuck, sir.
Identifying the forces, you will get stuck if you try to do the entire system at a stretch. You focus only on the individual part. You focus first on the block, then you focus on wedge A, then you focus on wedge B. You will not get any mistake.
Then after when I observe the your lecture note, then I can solve, I am doing the equation.
Raja, listen to me one thing. The question that I'm solving here, it is a pretty higher order question, right? So when I'm making you understand, you will understand. But why I am repeatedly asking you ki after every step, you do not look, now practice, do not look, now practice. Because it needs a rigorous practice to get a full perfection over it.
Yes, sir.
Got it. So you have the lecture note along with you. Now you need to practice this particular thing until that time you are feeling bored with that question. Then only you can be confident.
Okay, sir.
Got it. See, yes. I just give you a very simple example. All of you will understand ki when you are doing mechanics, you know, studying mechanics and solving question is directly equivalent to learning driving and driving on roads. When you learn driving for the first time, the instructor will tell you, okay, this is the first gear, this is second gear, this is third gear, fourth gear, fifth gear, this changes in that direction, that is the usage of clutch. So you keep everything on your mind, right? Through rigorous practice, after 2 years, when you drive on the road, do you remember all these things or it comes out of spontaneously?
Spontaneity.
Yes. So spontaneity will achieve out of practice, not out of anything else.
Yes. Okay.
Got,
sir. Thank you.
Got it? Right.
Yes.
Yes, Mr. Pushkar Kale.
Sir, same problem, sir. Force analysis karne aata hai, equation banane nahi aa raha, sir.
To ab tak to main wahi bol raha tha, bhai. It comes out of practice. Why I am telling you that you do not look at the lecture note and then write? Because remember, wherever you are not perfect, there exactly you will get stuck. When you are taking a rough copy, drawing the diagram and going for writing equation afresh, na, you will exactly get stuck on that step where you are not conceptually sound. So that I am asking you to do, because then only you will understand where exactly you are lagging. So wherever exactly you are lagging, then you get stuck, again refer the lecture note. Got it? So in that process, you will remember where you are getting stuck and what is your mistake. But if you just look at the lecture note and keep on practicing, you will never know what is your mistake, what is your deficiency. Okay, got my sir. Point? Right?
Answer.
Yeah. So now do it, everyone. Chalo. 3-4 minutes, everyone take. take the diagram afresh. Do you want to see the phrase diagram? I will bring it for you. Chalo, no issue. I will keep it for you so that you can just give a rough try. Chalo, everyone, do it. Altaf? Yes, Mr. Rahul?
Sir, at the block, normal reaction of block, the acting upwards and downwards, why, sir?
Which one?
At the block, normal reaction of the block acting downwards, no, sir.
Normal reaction is downward? Where?
Sir, in the previous page.
Where is acting downward?
Sir, up.
I will kill you. This is the normal reaction acting on the wedge surface.
No, sir.
Wait. Here you see. It is acting in the upward direction. That is the normal reaction exerted by the wedge surface to the block.
Okay, sir.
And after that, the same reaction we are getting on the wedge surface in the opposite direction.
Okay, sir.
Clear now?
Yes, sir.
Chalo. Okay. Do it. Yes, Altaf, tell me.
Sir, in your inter, you are also practicing like that only, sir.
Me?
Yes, sir.
In my inter?
Yes, sir.
I have a very unique style of study, actually, since I did not have any help from this coaching. You people are extremely lucky here. I was staying almost 35 kilometers from my district headquarters, so there was no help. You know how you used to study? You will laugh.
Tell, sir.
Suppose I used to see a question, then right. I used to see the solution of the question. So from the, listen, from the solution, I try to figure out the question.
Uh-huh.
So that is how I did it. And I tell you one thing. See, I everywhere tell this because I do believe that every single faculty, whosoever is teaching around the world should have this basic honesty to tell that behind your success, the contribution made by a teacher is not more than 2-3%.
Yes, sir.
So I'm telling you this thing very clearly. I can only show you the way how things can be done, but ultimately I will not have my admit card will come in your name, registration number you will only have, result will come in your name, and IIT you will go. So where am I?
But we will never forget you, sir.
That time will tell.
Yes, sir.
Chalo, do it. आकाश भाई,
तो जो वेज ए है,
हाँ,
तो दो तरफ टेंशन एक्ट कर रहा है ना, एक ब्लॉक के, तो फिर जब आपने फर्स्ट इक्वेशन लिखा तो उसमें आपने बस टी इनटू ए वन लिखा सर,
कांस्टेंट इक्वेशन मैंने जब लिखा,
यस सर,
तो आप फिर से गलत कर रहे हैं, कांस्टेंट मैं उसी तरफ लूंगा ना जिस तरफ एक्सेलरेशन है
सर, नेट नहीं लेंगे,
नहीं क्यों लेंगे, तू इधर क्या लिख क्या रहा है भाई, टी वेक्टर डॉट ए वेक्टर लेगा ना तू,
यस सर,
तो ये जो वेज है ऑन अ नेट, सोचने का कोशिश कर, ऑन अ नेट मूव कर रहा है किस एक्सेलरेशन के, किस टेंशन की वजह से, ये हॉरिजॉन्टल टेंशन की वजह से,
मतलब जिससे मूव करता है जिस फोर्स से उससे ए को मल्टीप्लाई करना,
राइट, उसी लेना। अब तू मुझे पूछेगा कि सर जब आप इक्वेशन लिख रहे हो तब टी कॉस थीटा क्यों ले रहे हो, because Akash, there is a difference between analyzing for the entire system and analyzing for the part of system. Tu jab pura system ke liye analyze karta hai tab internal forces cancel out ho jata hai, right? Yes, उसमें खाली एक्सटर्नल फोर्स काम करता है, पर मैं जब इंडिविजुअली एनालिसिस करता हूं तो उसमें तो हर एक फोर्स एक्सटर्नल फोर्स बन जाता है ना.
यस सर.
राइट, चलो आगे बढ़ो. व्हेन विल गो इनटू एग्जाम मोड सर? वी आर ऑलरेडी इन एग्जाम मोड डूड. दैट आई डिड नॉट टेल, वी आर इन एग्जाम मोड फॉर लास्ट 3 डेज ओनली. दिवित.
हेलो सर, व्हेन इज द एग्जाम सर? Today or tomorrow?
No idea. Tomorrow is Ganapati. In Hyderabad, this time Ganapati Puja is not happening.
Yes, sir.
Very sad.
Sir.
Last year, I purchased a lot of crackers. Shashi?
Sir, exam is today only, sir.
Is it so?
Yes, sir. Message came.
Congratulations.
Kal total holiday.
Now, since exam is today, now I have a ardent request for every one of you. For today's exam, I do not worry about the marks. For today's exam, I want perfection. From every one of you, I want perfection from all of you in today's exam. Because Newton's law is not about gathering knowledge. It's all about gathering concept. Correct? So if you are exactly perfect on certain particular thing, then only attempt that. Otherwise, leave. Peacefully leave. No problem. Okay? But still, I do believe whatever practice we have done till now, it is way more than enough. At least up to KBPI. Okay? So everybody got it? Chalo, raise your hand. How many were able to write the equation? Quickly raise your hand. Okay, 2 kacha mango bites. 1, 2, 3, 4. Are lot many did? Good. Okay. Now, how many wrote the equation with 5 to 10% fault? That means 1 or 2 equation did not get, but you almost got all the remaining. Out of 7 equation, who got more than 5 equations? Out of 7 equations, who got more 5 or more than 5 equations? Okay. Right. It's a good number. Very good. Right. Okay. Good. Fine. Chalo. That's all. I will not burden you more. One question is enough to puzzle you. So we have to practice this question again and again. In the afternoon session, I will also come up with some of this type of question on the little bit easier level. They will not be this much complicated and lengthy. Okay, no? Till then, chalo. Bye-bye. See you in the afternoon session. Bye.